Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos. So good morning one and all. We've seen the effect of acceleration in the suction side. Now we'll be seeing the effect of the acceleration head at the delivery side. So the effect of acceleration at delivery side was a pretty simple concept. A similar concept is at the delivery side as well. So let's see how it works. Now the effect of acceleration head at the suction and at the delivery is so let's see the effect of acceleration at delivery end. So we've seen the effect of acceleration at a suction end. So here the effect of acceleration head will be exactly opposite. So as we saw earlier that the effect of acceleration initially during suction stroke, the flow is retarded, it becomes zero, and then it becomes maximum, then it gains acceleration. So here the effect is exactly opposite. First, initially the initially at the start of the stroke, the acceleration head will be positive, it becomes zero, and then it becomes negative. So exactly opposite scenario. In at the pump, at the suction side, it was negative initially, negative, zero, then positive. Here it's positive, it becomes zero, and then negative. So the effect is exactly opposite at the delivery side. So when the pump is delivering the water, it has to pump the liquid by a head of HD and also by an acceleration of head of HAD. Now the pressure at the beginning of stroke is nothing but HD, that it has to pump through HD, and since the flow is accelerating at the initial end, it has to be positive, so the total pressure becomes HD plus HAD. Now at the middle of the stroke, that the value of HD becomes zero. We already seen that at 90 degree the cos component becomes zero at 90, so the HAD term will not be there, so it becomes zero. Now at the total, at the end of the stroke, that is at 0 degree, HD minus HAD will come because the cos of minus 180 is minus 1. So HD minus HAD. Now this is the distribution of pressure at the delivery side. So similarly, we had the distribution of pressure at the suction side. So now let's draw the graph for the effect of acceleration at the delivery side. And then what we'll do is we'll club both the graphs and see how the whole graph looks like. So this is the graph of the integrated diagram at the delivery end. So at the delivery end, the pressure has to be above atmospheric. At the suction end, we saw that everything was below the pressure, atmospheric pressure, because if, at the suction end, everything is working under vacuum, and at the delivery end, everything is well above the atmospheric pressure. Now what we'll do is we'll club both the graphs and see how the whole integrated diagram looks like. till now what I've drawn is an ideal indicator diagram without showing any effect of the acceleration head. So now if I include the effect of acceleration head in this diagram, it will look something like this. So this is how the whole graph looks like when you club both the indicator diagrams at the suction end, at the delivery end, including HS, including HAS, HD and HAD. So this is how the pressure variation takes place. So you get something like a parallelogram when you include the HAS and the HS. When you only consider HAS and HD, you get a kind of a rectangle, and the effect of HAS and HAD at the inlet of the pump and at the pumping side and at the delivery side is exactly opposite. So this is how the diagram looks like. So that was all about this topic. I hope you've understood everything, and we can solve a lot of numericals on these topics. Once you understand the concept, it's very easy to solve numericals. There can be numericals on this indicator diagram as well. So that was all about it. Thank you so much.